Speeches before were about work. I want to talk about life, life in general. That's why my first question is, do you like or do you love your life? If you don't know what the difference, imagine that you would have to repeat your life over and over and over again. Would you choose your life? I do ethnographic research, and we do research with thousands of people every year. What do you think they say? Who think it's love? That's very optimistic, a few people think that's why, but it's, most people think that the love is not for them. Why? Because they don't have enough money, they don't have enough friends, they're not talented enough, they don't have language skills, they don't have orientation skills, so they don't have many things, or they have too many of something, so they cannot afford to love their life. And people who love their life, they have all these things. And the only thing they forgot about is that everybody has its own King Kong. Everybody has something to fight with. Everybody. And the only difference is that the people who love their life, they just grab this King Kong, look at the eyes and say, I'm the boss. And that's the difference. And in order to do this, you need to have courage. You need to be brave. And these three things, usually when we need to be brave, we ask other people for help and we ask other people for support. And these people need to meet three requirements. It's time. We more trust people who we know for a long time. We know them, they know us, so we can trust. We do believe that they should love us, because we believe that if somebody loves us, they will not hurt us. And we also believe in power of good intention. If somebody wants good for us, it's probably going to be good for us. And this is the reason why we trust these people. And the only problem is that when we think that we can't do things or we don't have things, with the time, we start believing in our labels. And when more time passing, we're becoming our labels. So this is what we present. And people who meet these requirements are usually the one who see us on everyday basis with these labels. So in order to unstick these labels, what you need is to need to meet someone who see us as we are, not our labels. And these people are usually strangers, and these people usually do not meet all these requirements. So what I believe in is that with our labels, it's like with the clouds. Because when the clouds are in the sky, all the sky is gray. And strangers are like airplanes. You remember when you went the last time in the airplane? You go, you start when it's a gray sky, and you go up and up and up and up, and then you see gray clouds down, and the sky is blue again. And it was always blue. We just forgot about this. To order to be brave, you need to have trust in strangers, and I want to share with you three stories about trust in strangers. Before the TED, I was thinking about telling us stories from the research, because there are scientific research that proves it's true, or from my own research. But then I decided that I will, if I want to ask you to be brave and to be open, I also need to be brave and open and to share my private stories with you about my transformation. And to trust you that you will understand them, and to trust me that I will survive if you don't. So my first story, starts when I was born. And I was born in Soviet Union. It's a country without hope, without dreams, and your only future was determined by your label. And I found out about my label when I was 9, when my mom was asked to school, and my teacher said, your daughter is stupid. True story. No matter how hard she works, She all the time makes spelling mistakes. No matter how hard she tries, she's horrible in math, so she will not be able even to sell vegetables in a store. So my mom is a very good mom. She asks, so what could I do to help her? Let's pray. Let's pray she will be pretty, marry someone, and the summer will take care of her. That was my label. This, I believe I was born to be this way. And one day my mom decided that we're gonna move to Poland. So every day then in Poland, I was waiting when this day will come when they find out I'm stupid. And this day came. This day came, and when my Polish teacher said, I'm gonna read today essay of Julia. So I knew this is the day. And she said, it's the best essay I ever read in my life. And I asked her, how is it possible? I probably made a lot of mistakes. And she said, yeah, but it's just spelling. Don't worry about this. You work so hard, you can do anything in your life, and it's just spelling. So what this lesson taught me is that the woman knew me 3 years, and she thought I'm stupid. Another knew me 3 months, and she believed I'm intelligent, and I decided to trust her. That's why I truly believe that instead of trusting time, we should trust potential the stranger seeing us, and that just gives us way more strength. My second story goes when I already knew that I will be okay, and I decided to set up my own business. I decided not to risk and not to go into vegetable business, just in case. You never know. And what happened is that when I work a lot, and I work really a lot, and you know, because when everybody's saying you set up your company, you have to work. So it's true, I did work a lot. So for 3 years, I worked 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. I don't understand the words of weekends. Like for me, all days are Mondays. But that was fine. So when I decided to go on 3 weeks holiday, everybody said, you're crazy. People who have company, they don't go on 3 weeks holiday. You can't have cookie and eat cookie. So you just can stick there, watch out, and just be careful what's happening. So I went anyway. And everything was fine till I arrived here. It was Rapa Nui. Rapa Nui is Eastern Island, it's Polynesia. And do you remember when the first time you were in love? Like crazy in love. When every cell of your body was screaming about this person, when you could not wait to see it again, we just wanted to be every minute with this person. This is how I felt in Rapa Nui, and I fell in love in the island. And I did not really understand this feeling. I did not really understand why I want to stay there. I did not understand why I want to stay home, to make this place home. So day before I left, I decided to share my feelings with Anna Rapu, the person who owned the hotel where I was staying. She was seeing me every day during the breakfast. And I said, I don't know why I feel this way. I just want to stay, but I can't because I'm a rational person. I have the company and need to go back to watch out everything, so I can't stay. And she said, you know, some people think we are the end of the world. And it's true. But thousands of people every year come here to see the Moai. And they come to see Moai because they want to look at the eyes and they want to see something they already forgot and they don't have in their own world. They want to see impossible possible. Because nobody knows who built them. Nobody knows how they move there, but they're there. Because we are islands of warriors. And warriors, they do not ask if anybody did it before. They do not ask if you can. They just ask themselves what I want, and then they find the way. And when I look in your eyes, this is what I see. You're a warrior. You're one of us. Maybe your body was born in Poland, but your soul was born here. So you just find the way. You will manage. And I came back home, and everybody said, nice story. And it was a nice story. And I came back home, and I opened my computer, and I look in the eyes of Moai, and I bought a ticket. And this is how it started, that 4 months a year I spend traveling because I believe I can. So instead of putting so much trust into love, trust into stranger who believes you're a warrior and you can do anything in your life. And also, like, the other trick is you need to hire other warriors that believe that you can do impossible possible. And this is how I spent some time already in Rapa Nui being a warrior. My third story goes from the time when I start traveling so much. And when you travel so much, you get a lot of opinions. And I also get a lot of opinions. When I was in Latin America, they said, you know, you're like all Europeans, cold. And when you dance, you can't even move well. Like, your hips are not like Shakira hips. And I was coming back to Europe, they were saying, why are you such a drama queen? Everything happens, such a drama in your life. I was going to one of the clients and he was saying, you're so emotional, it's not professional. And I was going to another one. He was saying, I love that you're so emotional, you're such a fighter, I feel like you really care. I was telling some of my friends about my relationship problems and they were saying, oh, it's because you put your standards too high, you slow them down. And then I was going to another one and they say, it's because you have no standards. Just need to put them up, set up some standards. So whatever was happening with me was also too much or not enough. And I feel confused. It was the moment when I feel confused, I feel sad, I did not know what to do. And what do? When you don't know what to do, you go to your guru. And this is what I did. Thanks God, I was for a long time already Buddhist, so I did have my guru, I knew where to go. In Shambhala Buddhism, we have beautiful meditation center in France. This is where I went. And I asked for private meetings. They say no. But I was so desperate. I was so desperate that the final assistant of my teacher said, fine, 15 minutes, no more, 15. So I was thinking all night what to do, how to manage this, to put in 10 minutes everything was wrong with me, and then ask him the most important question, how should I change? What should I change? Which direction should I go? I came to the meeting, I told him in 10 minutes everything was supposed to say, and then asked him, so what should I do? And he stood up, he moved to the door, he opened the door, he called his assistant, and he said, please, call off all other students. We have a lot of work here. It was not that funny for me. I felt like my heart just dropped. You know that I knew that something wrong with me, but when Buddhist teacher saying that something wrong with you, it's not fun. And he came back to me and he said, tell me, how is it to be you? What do you like about being you? And I did not have answer because I forgot. For such a long time, I was trying to change myself because everybody who loved me, who cared about me, who had good intention was telling me, too much, not enough, too much, not enough, that I forgot how it is to be me. So he helped me to remind how it's to be me, to remind me in which situation I feel happy, complete, joyful, and that was very nice. But then I knew I need to have an answer. So I said, nice, but please tell me, what should I change? Where should I go? And he said the most profound thing I ever heard in my life, because he looked at me and said, I like you. I like you as you are. And if you need any advice, my advice is stop chasing the change. It will come and you will know and you will not have to ask anybody. Just rest your soul in peace. Just let your heart to be peaceful. Just enjoy your life and enjoy being you, because it's so great to be you. And I came back home and everybody said, oh, it's a nice story. And it was a nice story. And they said, but come on, be reasonable. He's Buddhist. What he's supposed to say? Of course he likes you. He likes... and it's obvious. He likes everyone. So it's not that you're special. He likes everyone. So let's be honest. You have to work on some stuff in your life. And that was an important decision in my life. I had opinion that again, something wrong with me. And that made me feel confused and sad and angry sometimes. And I have opinion of somebody else who said, you're complete, you're fine. So in this moment, I had to make a decision what to choose opinion that makes me feel confused or opinion that gives me wings to fly. And that was a very important decision in my life because I decided that I was born to fly. And as somebody who's born to fly, I need wings. And if I have two opinions, I decide which opinion gives me wings to fly high. And I believe we're all born to fly. So when we have to make this decision, when we get different opinions from different people, just choose the one that gives you wings to fly. And what all the stories have in common? These all stories about time, love, and intention, they just prove that for the reason you don't trust strangers, it's exactly the reason why you should trust them. Because they, maybe you don't know them for a long time, but because of this, they can see who you are now. They don't see your mistakes, they don't see your past. They don't see when you are different than you are now, they see you now. Love, the main reason what you want to do with the person when you love, you want to protect. And their goal is not to protect. The goal is to give you empowerment, encourage you to do stuff, to believe that you're a warrior, that you're born to fly. And intention, like we all know things about good intention. They're very nice, but not always very nice for us. So when I think about all strangers who helped me in my life, I feel very grateful because they taught me that my karma is not my label. It's my decisions who I make. And I make decision to trust people who give me wings, even if they're strangers and don't meet all these requirements. My name is Yulia Izmałkova, and I came really long way here to honor all the strangers who I meet in my life, who put light in my darkness of my life, and who's still on my way, and who helped me to become who I really am. Thank you very much.